Thanks for considering the views expressed in this ThinkTech commentary. Updating our infrastructure is not optional. There was a very important segment on 60 Minutes last Sunday. It was about the failure of the Port of Los Angeles and other ports and shipping hubs in the country. They're in trouble, and as a result the supply lines are being disrupted, and what is happening is affecting all of us. The ships and trucks aren't moving. The ships are stuck in the harbor and the trucks are stuck in the port. One of the big reasons is that these facilities are old and haven't been renewed or improved in some time. We as a country haven't been paying attention, and now we are paying the price. These facilities are clearly part of a national shipping system, but we have left the infrastructure to local government, who can't afford the cost. The federal government has failed on this, largely because of the GOP uncaring power politics in Washington. This has allowed our national shipping system to slip well behind Europe and Asia, which are way ahead of us. The result is that shipping times and shortages have dramatically increased, and the cost of shipping has skyrocketed. To add insult to injury, shippers are now also being charged storage for the containers they are waiting for. They cannot afford to pay these huge and often tenfold increases in the costs of shipping. So if they want to stay in business, they have to pass these costs on to consumers. And that in turn results in higher prices for all of us, and creates significant inflationary pressures. We cannot afford to have this inflation. The disruption to the supply lines goes way beyond Christmas gifts. It involves fuel oil and every kind of product and import you can think of, including of course produce and food. With the help of a grant from the Cook Foundation, and through the efforts of local filmmaker Kim Basford, ThinkTech is making a film on agriculture in Hawaii. Given the trouble with the national supply lines, Hawaii's long-time dependence on imported food is a threat to us. Beyond our inability to grow our own, there is also a serious climate change drought in the West, particularly in the Columbia River Basin, and this becomes another threat for our imported food supply. Given these threats, Hawaii is at risk of not being able to get enough food. The film should be released next year, when these things may be of even greater concern. The cities and states cannot solve the problem. They need infrastructure funding from the federal government to catch up. Joe Biden's infrastructure bill is critical to that effort, and now that the bill has finally passed, we can only hope the money will soon find its way to the ports and shipping facilities to get things going again. The White House has said it will put a priority on this, and that's encouraging. But this all points out that the federal government has been dysfunctional over the last few years. Trump campaigned on infrastructure and talked about it until we were all blue in the face, but he did nothing. On the other hand, it can't stop with the success of Joe Biden's infrastructure bill. We must always and continually maintain and upgrade our infrastructure, the roads, the bridges, the electrical grid and these shipping facilities, and we must do that nationally, not locally. Now that we have seen what happens, we can see that infrastructure is a very real and pressing priority. Indeed, infrastructure must always be a priority in order to sustain our economy. And hopefully all the members of Congress will soon come to understand that. Thanks for considering the views expressed in this commentary. Mahalo for watching.